Look, I get it. I'm a petrol head at heart too, and I love a good exhaust note. But at $2,500 per year for insurance on a sweet ride like this, and with regular maintenance costs and upkeep, the fun it brings is a little contradicting to the freedom it provides when you end up needing to work your ass off to afford the bills for it. Want to go downtown and park? That'll be about $10. Need a new set of these super sporty tires? That's going to be $952 per tire. That's about the cost of the most expensive part on one of our Enduro e-bikes. And with fuel at $2 per liter, it's going to leave you pretty restricted to actually go out and have some fun in this sweet whip. Electric transportation isn't a new thing. In 1888, the German Andreas Flocken designed the Flocken electric wagon, and it was flocken fast for its time. But it's 2024, and the electric technology has advanced immensely since then. This 12,000 watt Enduro e-bike can reach top speeds of 100 kilometers per hour, can travel between 100 to 200 kilometers at minimum, dependent upon the pack size, and can be built with a mind-blistering 221 foot-pounds of torque. I think if there's one thing that could still use improving, it's the bike's diet. You cram in those kind of specs on a bike like this, and 174 pounds starts to tip the scales between keeping the bike well planted on the ground and making it difficult to lug around. I think the saying goes, the bigger they are, the harder they fall, or in this case, the bigger they are, the harder they are to steal. Any wannabe thieves seeing a bike with these kind of high-end components is sure to gain some interest. That's why we've equipped the bike with remote GPS tracking and real-time tamper notifications, as well as an alarm system and key fobs with rear motor locking.
Man, this is a pretty nice bike. Sure would be a shame if someone stole it. What the heck? Who put this stupid alarm on this thing? Ah, it doesn't even matter. You're coming with me anyways. Why is it so hard to move? Ah, screw it. Someone else could take this stupid bike.
You wouldn't want a bike like this that brings those kind of smiles to be stolen without your consent. With a 0 to 60 time of around 2 to 3 seconds, the bike's extremely fast. And with these pedals, once you're done messing about in the backcountry, you can ride legally and safely as if it were a normal pedal bike, and keep that freedom to not pay any insurance, registration, gas, or parking fees wherever your next adventure takes you. In today's market, we're being made to pay for everything, even camping on Crown land. It's nice to go back to the good old days and not have to pay to go have fun.